In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 2 free worksheet distance, rate, time, word problems. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. I'm going to break this worksheet up into three separate videos, doing four problems in each video. So in this video, the first part of this worksheet, I'm going to do numbers 1 through 4. In number 1, it says a container ship left the Dania Pier and traveled north. An aircraft carrier left 4 hours later, traveling at 30 miles per hour in effort to catch up to the container ship. We know they're going the same direction and that the aircraft carrier left 4 hours later or after the container ship, and it was traveling at 30 miles per hour. After traveling for 8 hours, so the aircraft carrier traveled 8 hours, it finally caught up to that container ship. So we're trying to figure out what was the container ship's average speed. Let's go ahead and make the average speed a variable, let's say A. So our variable A represents the average speed of the container ship. We know that since the aircraft carrier finally caught up to the container ship, they both traveled the same distance. And in order to get distance, we will multiply speed by the time traveled. So let's look at the container ship first. We know that the aircraft carrier caught up after it traveled 8 hours. And it also left 4 hours after the container ship had already left. So 8 plus 4 will give us the total number of hours that the container ship traveled. And if we were to multiply that by our variable A, the average speed, we would get the distance traveled. And that distance is equal to the distance that the aircraft carrier traveled. The aircraft carrier traveled for a total of 8 hours, and it traveled 30 miles per hour. Now we just solve for A. 8 plus 4 equals 12, so 12 hours times A is equal to 8 hours times 30 miles per hour, which is 240 miles. Our last step is to divide by 12 hours. We're going to get that A is equal to 240 miles divided by 12 hours, which is 20 miles per hour. So 20 miles per hour is our answer for number 1. So let's go back to this step here. We got that 12 hours times A is equal to 240 miles. 240 miles is the total distance that the aircraft carrier traveled, and in turn, also the total distance that the container ship traveled. So all we'd have to do is divide by the time that that container ship took to travel that distance to get the average speed. And that is 20 miles per hour. Let's continue on to number 2. In number 2, a cruise ship made a trip to Guam and back. The trip there took 12 hours, and the trip back took 9 hours. It averaged 20 kilometers per hour on the return trip, so that's the trip back. And we're finding the average speed of the trip there. So the average speed of the trip there, let's call that variable x. So the trip there took 12 hours, and if we multiply the time that trip took by the average speed, which the trip there took x kilometers per hour, that's going to equal the distance it took to get there. However, the distance it takes to get to Guam is the same as the distance it takes back from Guam. So the trip back took 9 hours and it averaged 20 kilometers per hour on that return trip. That will give us the distance it took to get back, which we know is equal to the distance that it took to get there. So 12 hours times x is equal to 9 hours times 20 kilometers per hour. 9 times 20 is 180. So the distance is 180 kilometers. You can think of the label hours as canceling out, since this hours is in the numerator and this is in the denominator. That is why our new label is now just kilometers. Our next step is to divide by the time it took for the cruise ship to get to Guam. X is going to be equal to 180 kilometers divided by 12 hours, which will be 15 kilometers per hour. And that is the average speed of the trip there. Let's move on to number 3. In number 3, it says that Scott left the airport and traveled toward the train station. 3 hours later, so 3 hours after Scott left, Castle left, traveling at 50 miles per hour in an effort to catch up to Scott. After traveling for 2 hours, Castle finally caught up to Scott. What was Scott's average speed? So our variable is going to represent Scott's average speed. And let's have that variable be y. So the total time that Scott traveled times his average speed will give us his total distance. Castle left 3 hours after Scott and traveled for 2 hours until he actually caught up. So the total time Scott was traveling will be 3 plus 2 hours. And we're going to multiply that by his average speed, y. That distance is going to equal the distance that Castle traveled. So Castle traveled for a total of 2 hours at 50 miles per hour. 3 plus 2 will give us 5 hours, and we're multiplying that by Scott's average speed, y, and that's equal to 2 hours times 50 miles per hour, which will be 100 miles. 100 miles is the distance that Castle traveled, and it's also the distance that Scott traveled. So we're going to divide by the time it took Scott to travel those 100 miles, which is 5 hours, to get his average speed. 100 miles divided by 5 hours will give us 20 miles per hour. So Scott's average speed was 20 miles per hour. And now our final problem in this video, number 4. However, before I go over the answer to this, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. For number 4, Jose traveled to the town hall and back. The trip there took 5 hours and the trip back took 4 hours. He averaged 35 kilometers per hour on that return trip. So on the trip back, which took 4 hours, he averaged 35 kilometers per hour. We're finding the average speed of the trip there. Let's make this variable z. So z represents the average speed. The trip there took 5 hours, and we're going to multiply that by the average speed of the trip there, which is z. That's going to be equal to the trip back, which took 4 hours, and that speed was 35 kilometers per hour. So we have 5 hours times z is going to be equal to 4 hours times 35 kilometers per hour, which is 140 kilometers. Our last and final step is to divide by 5 hours to get that z is equal to 140 kilometers divided by 5 hours, which is 28 kilometers per hour. So 28 kilometers per hour is our solution in number 4. Feel free to join me in the next video where I'll complete problems 5 through 8.